tell us what you liked about the president's speech first.
Well, you know, I think he made a good point that atrocities occurred, you know, that there was something awful that happened, the gas attacks. You can't watch them without having a great deal of sympathy for the people. But I guess my first response to that is, well, gosh, the guy who did this deserves death. I mean, the death penalty for killing civilians.
Bashar al-Assad.
Yeah, but I mean, the president's plan is to leave Assad alone. Well,
do you think he should go in there and try to kill him?
Well, the thing is that I think his plan, though, is to spare Assad, to leave the regime in place. But at the same time, he says someone must pay for breaking this international norm, but he's really not willing to actually make Assad pay. I think there should be a way that Assad pays, either through an international tribunal or something. I think Assad can't remain there.
Targeted assassination?
Well, I'm not really saying that. What I'm arguing is that what the president has planned is not going to accomplish what he says he's going to accomplish, which is to punish Assad for this. I think Assad personally will not be held accountable for this. I also think that even if the diplomatic solution occurs, that he still may not be accountable because it may still leave him
in place. You hope that this Russian initiative works, right?
I do. I think that the military option, it has no clear military objective. I think if we bomb Assad, I think it'll be more likely that the country becomes more unstable, refugees become worse, perhaps Israel gets attacked. And I think also the real danger to bombing Assad is that the chemical weapons may become loose within the country and may be taken over by either terrorists or al-Qaeda.
Because the president has a different analysis. Let me play a clip from what we just heard from the president.
Get involved at all in a place that's so complicated, and where, as one person wrote to me, those who come after Assad...